We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Students, welcome to the last unit of your basic physics course, that is unit number 5, and we will start this unit with very interesting topic. Have you ever wondered that you can use the gaseous elements of our universe to fabricate a laser? So I hope that you may have forgot the full form of laser. I am sure that you all have utilized the laser instrument in your childhood for some fun making activities, but I am even assured that you all may not aware with the full form of laser. In case you know, that's good for you, for your career. So the full form of laser, we will start this article like this. The full form of laser is L stands for light emitting stimulated emission radiation. Okay, so light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation, this is the full form of laser. This particular article entitled as helium neon laser. Why this helium and neon words have been utilized? Because we know helium and neon are two well-known gaseous elements of our universe, and these two gases have been utilized to fabricate this laser, and it is globally known as HENE laser. In this particular article, we are going to observe its principle, its construction, that means what are the components of this laser, how they have arranged in that setup, and we will lastly see the working of this particular laser, that means how the photon light is generated by use of this helium and neon gases. Okay, so we will understand first of all that what is HENE or helium neon laser. So helium neon laser is a type of gas laser, because the gaseous elements have been utilized, in which a mixture of helium and neon gas is used as a gain medium. Okay, we will see the detailed of this gain medium in the construction parameters. Helium neon laser is also known as HENE laser in their acronym form. The helium neon laser was the first continuous wave CW laser ever constructed. It was built in 1961 by Elijevon, Bennett and Harriet at Bell Telephone Laboratories. Helium neon lasers are the most widely used gas lasers, and you may have seen the application of laser in the metal cutting processes. So the gaseous laser are widely used in this particular kind of applications. And it is mentioned in the next line. See, these lasers have many industrial and scientific uses and are often used in laboratory demonstrations of optics. So, in HENE laser, the optical pumping method is not used. Instead, an electrical pumping method is used, where excitation of electrons in the HENE gas active medium is achieved by passing an electric current through the gas. So here we are going to observe very interesting phenomenon. See, we have seen the interaction of electric current with some elements, but first time ever we are going to observe the interaction of electric current with the gaseous medium. So at my point of view, it will be very interesting. So here, this is the construction where this is your anode, this is your cathode, where the DC power supply has been connected. So negative pole to cathode, positive pole to anode, where in between the glass tube, this is your glass tube, and this is the high reflector end. You will see each and every parameter in detail, but first of all, we are analyzing the components have been utilized in this particular construction. This is the mixture of your helium and neon gas. This is the output coupler from which the photon lights are emitted. Inside the glass tube, a mixture of helium and neon gas is added, where the two poles, anode and cathode, are further connected to the DC power supply, and the electric current flowing through this supply will directly in contact with this gaseous mixture inside the glass tube, and we will observe that what is the working procedure or working prospects by which the interaction of the electric currents from this DC power supply to the helium and neon gas mixture, they converted into the photon energy with which the light rays are emitting from this. So quite interesting topic, easy and simple construction. Okay, you have to draw this kind of nomenclature figure in your GPU examination. Now we will see the construction part in detail. Okay, so the helium neon laser consists of three essential components. Number one is the pump source, which is our high voltage power supply, and hence in the introduction or principal section we also have clarified that instead of population inversion, instead of optical pumping, we have used electrical pumping, and that's why we have used the high voltage power supply. Number two is the gain medium, where the laser glass tube, or we can say discharge glass tube, has been utilized. And the last one is resonating cavity, which works as a dielectric medium, which we also going to observe. In order to produce the laser beam, it is essential to achieve population inversion mechanism, which is the process of achieving more electrons in the higher energy state as compared to the lower energy state. So the basic concepts of electronic materials is also applicable over here, like valence band and conduction band. Here they are termed as the lower or ground energy or excited energy states. In general, the lower energy state has more electrons than the higher energy state in the absence of electric field. However, after achieving the population inversion means what? If you have the high amount of electrons in the lower energy states and less amount of electrons in the higher energy state, the exactly opposite phenomenon you are going to achieve when the population inversion mechanism is obtained. So more electrons will remain in the higher energy state than the lower energy state. So this is the basic principle on which helium neon gas laser is working, which is of population inversion. So to attain the population inversion phenomenon in this HENE laser, the gain medium of a HENE laser is made up of the mixture of helium and neon gas contained in a glass tube at very low pressure, and the partial pressure for helium is 1 millibar, whereas for neon the pressure is maintained at 0.1 millibar. The gas mixture is mostly comprised of helium gas, so a large amount of helium gas is utilized in comparison to that of neon. Therefore, in order to achieve population inversion, we need to excite primarily the lower energy state electrons of the helium atoms, and they should be traveled to the higher energy state of neon gas. So DC power supply will have the duty to lift these electrons from lower energy states to higher energy states. In HENE laser, neon atoms are the active centers and have energy levels suitable for laser transitions, while helium atoms help in exciting neon atoms. And that's why the glass tube containing a mixture of helium and neon gas is placed between two parallel mirrors, and these two parallel mirrors are silvered or optically coated. You have seen these particular mirrors, so these mirrors are silver or optically coated. Now we will see the working of HENE laser. First of all, you observe this ground state condition, okay, where the helium gas is utilized. The F1, F2, F3, F4 and F5 are the increasing order of the energy states, where F1 is the lowermost energy level and F5 is the highermost energy level. Our duty is to lift the higher amount of electrons, which is at present in F1 energy level. We have to lift them into the energy level F5. So high speed energetic electrons, which were introduced by means of external DC power supply to anode and cathode contacts of glass tube, okay, and that's why after the bombarding high speed energetic electrons, you can see some amount of electrons has been lifted to F3 and F5 energy states respectively. Okay, so this process is known as excitation due to the collision of electrons. So by bombarding the excess amount of electrons, this some amount of electrons have been lifted to the higher energy levels. Next, from this higher energy level, due to the helium electrons colliding with the ground state electrons of neon, because there is a combination of helium and neon gas mixture, so this is the basic condition or the stable condition of neon gas. Again, 5 energy levels from E1 to E5. For neon gas, we have utilized the symbol E1 to E5, and for helium, we have represented the energy level as F1 to F5. Now see, the excess electrons in the helium gas are now traveled to the ground state level of neon gas, and this is due to colliding of helium and neon gas respectively. Moreover, due to the helium electrons fall back to the ground state, because now the excess energy has been lifted out, so at that particular time the totally inverse process, because some flow of electrons will be transferred to the neon, and hence neon electrons will simultaneously excite to the metastable, that means the higher energy states. And this was our target, to attain higher amount of electrons in the higher energy states of either helium, either neon gas. But due to the low pressure of neon for high reflectivity concept, we have suggested for neon to get excitement of electron. And in the last process, neon electrons releasing photons while falling to the lower energy states. See, in the case of helium atoms, the energy which was released by traveling of electron from higher energy to lower energy state, it was utilized by neon atoms to travel in the excited state. When the population inversion mechanism is achieved by means of the lifting of electrons from higher energy to lower energy states, the release amount of energy is now converted into the photon energy, which you can see from this blue wave, continuous wave factor, and that particular wave is colliding with this high reflector, because the higher amount of energy will be generated due to this working principle, and this will be reflected towards this output coupler, which is the resonator cavity. And here at this particular point, output coupler, we will get the laser output, and the laser output will be of uniform shape. okay, which was not in the case of semiconductor laser. So this was all about the construction principle and working of HEMI laser. This particular video will be helpful to gain minimum of 7 marks in your GTU examination. And if you recall or review the papers of GTU exam of previous years, then this question is definitely asked in 7 marks. Okay, so I suggest that you must prepare this particular article for your good marks gaining in the GTU examination. So I hope that you all have now clear idea about this HENE, that is helium neon laser, and will have also explained each and every detail of its component side, its working principle, and the basic functionality of helium and neon gases and their energy levels. So thanks for visiting this lecture.